Hi there. This one will be short and sweet, but I wanted to share this project. I've always been a fan of these new Ford Raptors, and in this case, one of our repeat clients who's become a good friend bought one and asked us to dial it in a little bit. His idea was not to create a monster truck, sand monster, any of that. It's really more of a street daily driver truck, but he wanted to sort of enhance the truck and make it a bit more bespoke than factory. So we repainted the truck in a really cool Ferrari color called Grigio Scuro with a matte clear coat. Then I laser scanned the front grille, the hood vents, the fender vents, and the rear center emblem slash camera holder, and then CNC'd all of those in billet aluminum, and then powder coated them in the Icon volcanic black finish. We, as you can see here, added copious amounts of LED auxiliary lighting. I mean, it's just stupendous. It's just like a mobile stadium lighting vehicle. And in the rear, we upgraded the rear taillight assemblies to the LED units that are really quite nice by Rigid Industries, the auxiliary lights, and the taillights by Recon Industries. There you see my hood vents, which are quite similar to the stock, except I played with the crown and radius and surface. And then on these fender vents, similar to stock, but I integrated the mesh pattern borrowed from the front grille, as well as the G, which is the logo of my client's ranch. On the inside of the
Oh
truck, we
my
pretty
gosh.
much left it
But in the
stock, except we
meantime, what
gutted
are
it,
Richter's
dynamatted
impending
every surface we
disease
could get
and
our
the
hands on,
morality of
and put it
creating
all back
embryos
together
that
and
will then be
integrated these
destroyed
in
economically?
headrests, iPod, nav, audio, blah, 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 little entertainment systems. My buddies at Max Tie-Downs helped us add utility in the cargo area by doing the rail-mounted CNC'd aluminum system. Then we have a removable bed-mounted spare for the fifth method racing wheel and some CNC'd anchors also by our friends at Max Tie-Down. You also note there's polyurea coating there. These are the new wheels, 17-inch by 8.5 by Method Racing. We didn't like the cab-plated Erudite hardware, so we upgraded those to stainless. Suspension system on the truck is quite comfortable and capable. It's the Outlaw Raptor 3.5 using uniball upper A-arms and triple bypass shocks. Other than that, mechanically, we did a K&N intake, modified the exhaust tips, and really kind of left it alone. We put 37-inch BF Goodrich 12.5 by 17 all-terrains on there to fill the wells a little bit more. And then you may have noticed those front fenders are the new versions made by Glassworks with just released inner liners. Due to the lift, to provide comfort for ingress egress, we used my beloved Power Steps by Amp Research to really make it a lot more comfortable for getting in and out. Let's see, what else did I do? The back bumper is from SDHQ, although my bad, I modified that too. So I changed the lighting, I got rid of the plastics, redid it in aluminum, smoothed the logos off, and just kind of classed it up. Here's the G logo in the rear, replacing the factory Ford, still allowing the integration of the factory reverse camera. And that's my whole story. This truck was really a blast to do. We now have CAD files on all these trim components, which we can tweak for the next clients. But there's something about the Raptor platform that's just so much fun. And John and his team over at SVT really did such an excellent job on it. It was a great platform for us to play.